Hi, welcome to the Numeracy 5-a-day answers for the 18th of May. So the first question says, shade 3/5 of this grid. Now if you look at this grid, I can see that there's, because we're trying to shade in 3/5, I can actually see there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns. So I'm going to shade in 3 of them. So 3 columns would look something like this if I shaded them in. And that would be 3/5, just shading in 3 of the 5 columns. Alternatively, I could have said, well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so there's 20 squares altogether. 3/5 of 20, well, 1/5 of 20 is 4, and times that by 3 is 12, and then you just shade in 12 little squares, and that's kind of what I've done there, but quite badly. Okay, next question. Our next question says, this is drawn on a centimeter square grid, and says, what is the area of the shape? So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so there's 5 squares shaded, so the area would be 5 centimeters squared. Then the next question says, what is the perimeter? So along the top is 1, 2, 3 centimeters. Here, there's another 1 centimeter. Here, there's another 1. And here, there's another 1. Along the bottom is 2 centimeters. And up the side is 2 centimeters. So we're going to add together 3 + 1 + 1 + 1 + 2 + 2. So 3 + 1 = 4. + 1 = 5. + 1 = 6. + 2 = 8. And + 2 = 10. So the perimeter is 10 centimeters. Okay, our next question. Our next question says, arrange the following numbers in order from smallest to largest. So here we've got decimals and percentages. I'm going to change them all to percentages. To get to from a decimal to a percentage, you multiply by 100. So 0.61 would be 61%, 59%. 0.6 would be 60%. And then we've got 62%. And arranging them in order, well, the smallest would be 59%. Then the next one would be 60, because we're going from smallest to largest, would be 60%, which is 0.6. Our next number would be 0.61, which is 61%, and our final one would be 62%. Okay, our next question. Our next question says, we now have this packets of plates. There's a small pack which contains 3 plates for £5.25, or there's a large pack which contains 12 plates for £21.24. So what we're going to do is we're going to find which one is better value for money. Now what I could do is, in this question, I could divide £5.25 by 3 to find the cost of one plate. And then I could do £21.24 divided by 12 to find the cost of one plate and compare them. Now I'm actually going to do this question a slightly different way. As you can see here, the small pack contains 3 plates and the large pack contains 12 plates. Now if I buy 4 small packs, that's 4 packs of 3, that's 12, I can find out the cost of 12 plates using small packs, and then I can compare it to the large pack and see which one's better value for money. So I'm going to buy 4 packs of these, so 4 packs. So we're going to do 4 times £5.25. So £5.25 times by 4 would be, 4 times 5 is 20, put the 0 down, carry the 2. 4 times 2 is 8, plus 2 is 10, so put the 0 down, carry the 1. And 4 times 5 is 20, plus 1 is 21. So buying 12 plates using the small packs costs £21. And buying 12 plates by using the large pack would cost £21.24. So the question says, which is better value for money? Well, the better value for money is the small pack. Okay, and our next question. Our next question, here we've got a four-sided shape, a quadrilateral, and we've been given 3 angles, 120 degrees, 130 degrees, and 75 degrees, and we've been asked to find the size of this angle here, y. Now I know that the angles in a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. So if we add up these 3 angles and take them away from 360 degrees, we'll see what's left for y. So 130, 120, and 75, let's add those up. So 0 plus 0 plus 5 is 5. 3 plus 2 is 5 plus 7 is equal to 12, so put the 2 down and carry the 1. And 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. So adding up those 3 angles gives us 325 degrees. So if we do 360 subtract 325, we'll see what's left for y. So 0 take away 5, we can't do, so we'll borrow, so that's 5 and a 1. 10 take away 5 is 5, 5 take away 2 is 3, and 0, 3 take away 3 is 0, so the answer would be 35 degrees.